Hey, this is SGU, and welcome back to the Billy Bravo Career Mode series here in Madden 17 on the Xbox One. Today is the big game, the Super Bowl. The Broncos have gotten back here on back-to-back seasons. Of course, that won't be happening in real life, but in Billy Bravo's world, all he does is win championships. He won one with the Colorado Rockies in baseball, his second straight World Series championship, and now he goes for the Super Bowl with the Broncos.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The big game is here, and what a special moment for this guy, doing what so many never get a chance to do in their career, play quarterback in the Super Bowl. It's the Broncos going up against the Falcons. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Larry, they broke ground on this place in the year 2000, opened it in August of 2002, and it's been the home of this franchise ever since. Welcome to NRG Stadium in Houston. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here between the Denver Broncos and the Atlanta Falcons. I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left is my good friend Charles Davis, and what a thrill to be here for the biggest one of them all, the Super Bowl. And it seems to get bigger every year. The lights get brighter, the cameras more numerous. I don't know, there's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no longer just a game for America or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll.
So Broncos and Falcons, not only a rematch of Super Bowl 33, which was John Elway's triumphant last game in the league, winning his second straight Super Bowl. We're throwing it back to the same uniforms worn in that game as well. Atlanta wearing their throwbacks. I don't know why they'd want to revisit that painful history. And speaking of painful history, that was the year the Falcons beat my Minnesota Vikings in the NFC Championship game, a game that still haunts me to this day. Vikings had only lost one game all year, but then wide right by Gary Anderson, he missed his first kick of the year. And, well, the Falcons went to the Super Bowl, and they got whitewashed by the Denver Broncos. I'd like to think the Vikings might have done something different in that game. You know, you got to play the what-if game, but that's history. It's in the books, and here we go with the rematch of Super Bowl 33 here in Super Bowl 51. Denver and Atlanta taking each other on, so the Broncos get the football first, and it's going to be C.J. Anderson trying to develop a running game going here. That's been kind of a facet of the Broncos' offense that really has not been clicking in the latter half of the season, but they've been able to get on a roll despite that and get themselves to the Super Bowl here when it looked like they might not even make the playoffs at one point. They rushed back into things, took the division title, kind of like the Green Bay Packers have going on in real life here. A late season surge as you see Bravo connecting for a first down. It's going to be first and 10, and here comes C.J. Anderson. We're getting good push on the offensive line early on here, and if that continues, that's going to make things a lot easier for the rookie signal caller. Now he's going to stand in there and get hit, but he delivers the ball to Demaryius Thomas, who will get close to first down yardage. It'll be third and one, fullback in the game. He's going to get the lead block, and Anderson doesn't get much, but it looks like he's got enough for a first down at the 21-yard line. And now on second and 10, dropping back, trying to set up a screen. That will be to Anderson, and he cannot get away from the initial tackle, taken down. And it's going to be third and 11 from the 21. Throwing over the middle, though, it's Emmanuel Sanders. He's got to adjust back for that football to make sure he makes the catch. But it is first and goal at the 4-yard line. Hits him in stride, maybe. That's the first touchdown of the game. But C.J. Anderson will handle those duties as he scampers in with the run. Touchdown, Broncos, and they're up 7-0 in Super Bowl 51. Let's watch it again here. Nice blocking up front, and he's able to find his way into the end zone for the game's first score. So the Broncos offense has done their part. What will Matt Ryan and the Falcons offense do on their drive here in the second quarter? A lot of time taken off the clock there by the Broncos on their drive, but it's a 14-yard touchdown pass to Devontae Freeman from Matt Ryan, and we're all tied up at 7-7 here in the early stages of the second quarter. Let's get it going again with C.J. Anderson running right up the middle, and again a good push. We got 6 carries for 30 yards and that touchdown for him. Like how things are developing in the first half for him. Now he goes off right tackle, and will he have a first down? Yes, first and 10 at the 36. You see our quarterback, Billy Bravo, pumped up right here as he is trying to rise to the occasion of the big stage, the big game. He's going to roll to the right here, and he's not going to run. He's going to eventually just dump that to his man for a first down. Nice, easy little toss ahead of him about 5 yards and let his receiver do the work. Third and 11 now on the same drive, though, at the 46. Standing in the pocket, throwing over the middle, and, oh, Virgil Green is tight end. Haven't heard from him yet today, but he makes a nice catch right in front of a defender, shielding with his body there to make the catch. Virgil Green has been a big target for Bravo all season, and nothing's changed right there. There's a handoff to Anderson, and he's going to get 5 yards, second and 5. And on that play, taking a very quick drop back, and maybe not far enough back in the pocket right there as he is stripped and fumbled. Now, luckily, the Broncos fall on that, and yep, my fault, says Bravo. Although, you got to kind of keep some people off of him, like right there again. The pressure in his face, and that's an incomplete pass. Rule, 4th and 9. Chance for a long field goal, and Brandon McManus nails it. 53-yarder, giving Denver back the lead at 10-7. The defense makes a stop, and with 4 minutes before halftime, we have the football back. It's 3rd and 5, however. Throw to the flat. That's C.J. Anderson, and he is able to get past the first down marker there, move the chains. So 2nd and 10 now. And he's going to load up one-on-one. Emmanuel Sanders, and oh my goodness, what a catch. Comes down on the back of the receiver there, but secures the football. Those are the kind of one-on-one shots you want to take when you see the coverage rolling away from that side from the safeties. He knows he's got one-on-one and a good chance for Emmanuel Sanders to make a play, and that's exactly what he does right here. Super Bowl caliber effort from a veteran and a star, Emmanuel Sanders, right there. And that's going to set him up at the 23-yard line, knocking on the door of the red zone. 1st and 10, all kinds of time to throw, and it allows Emmanuel Sanders to get open, this time kind of cutting into the middle of the field. He'll have a first down at the 10-yard line. They lose a couple yards at 2nd and 12. And again, going to the flat to Anderson, trying to make a man miss. Nope, this time a solid tackle. He's going to be down at the 7, and it's going to be 3rd and 7. Broncos looking to dial up the right play right here to get him into the end zone. Rush in his face, but he gets it off to his tight end, and it's a touchdown. Great catch right there with a defender right on him. But the concentration is great here for Garrett Graham. Makes the catch, secures it, as you see the defender try to knock it on out of there, but not gonna do it. Touchdown Broncos, and it's 17-7, the 10-point lead. Matt Ryan coming down the field here in the third quarter now, but no, they cannot do anything with it, and the Broncos have the football back up 10 here early in the second half. They gotta like where they're sitting right now. 3rd and inches. Fullback in the game, Janovich, and wow, didn't need the fullback there as that parted nicely for C.J. Anderson. He could have driven his truck through there, I believe, as that was quite an open lane right up the middle. 2nd and 12, and speaking of an open lane for the Falcons rushers to take down Billy Bravo right there. 3rd and 18, can he convert the throw? Nope, that's going to be knocked away. Had his hands on it, but that's a tough throw and completion to make. It's going to be 4th down, and they punt. Atlanta takes that football, drives down at the waning stages of the third quarter, and punches it in for a touchdown. Extra points good. We got a 3-point ball game as the fourth quarter starts. 2nd and 7, a nice little pass right there to Virgil Green. And again, Virgil Green has a first down. Not called upon a lot in this game, but when he does, he has been reliable right there for him. C.J. Anderson again on 3rd and 9, just trying to get him in space with a chance to make some cuts. Couldn't do it right there. Atlanta's got the football back with a chance to take the lead. No, they couldn't get anything right there. It's still 17-14. Denver's football with just under 6 minutes to play, and nice throw on third and long. Did they get the first down? Oh, they're just 1 yard short. Fourth and one. Great effort here on Bravo and third and forever to try to pick it up, but look at the tackle, just stopping Demaryius Thomas short of the first down. It's time to punt. 5 minutes left now. What will the Falcons do with the football? 6 yard reception, and oh, we have a turnover? Is it a turnover? What happened right here? Could have been a long pass attempt and interception. I don't know, but we got the football back with just over 4 minutes of play, and on second and long, the screen pass works. It's a first down for C.J. Anderson, and that is huge. It takes us under 4 minutes. Atlanta going to have to start burning timeouts soon. This could be the play of the game if the Broncos go on to hang on. Look at this. Nice play right there. Stays in bounds long enough to get a first down, working down that sideline. They got a third and inches now, just ahead of the 2 minute warning. Can they get a first down? Quarterback sneak. Yes. Bravo falls forward and gets it. 2 yards and a first down. That will bring us to the 2 minute warning. And on the other side of this, Atlanta will have to start using timeouts to try to get this football back. One more first down and this could be over. Second and nine. Going to be pitch outside to C.J. Anderson. He kind of makes a cut there. I was worried he was going to go out of bounds. Doesn't get much, and it's a timeout by the Falcons. They have one left. So now, third and 10. You don't want to do anything too aggressive, and we just try to check down to Anderson, but that's not a good pass. It falls incomplete, and here we let Atlanta have one of their timeouts remaining and getting the football back. So now it's on the shoulders of the Denver defense. Can they hold them here? Will the Falcons drive and tie the game, or get the winning touchdown under a minute? 14-yard reception to Nick Williams. They're at the 24, 31 seconds. Pass knocked away by Von Miller. Second and 10, 4-yard rush by Matt Ryan. He runs again, and it's all over.
Lombardi Trophy goes west, and it goes to the Denver Broncos, your Super Bowl champs. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. That actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
We'll get to the Super Bowl trophy presentation in a second here, but trying to look at what happened. Apparently, Matt Ryan scrambled away for 4 yards, but they ran out of time to kick a field goal. Thought for sure they would send this thing to overtime with the field position they were at, but apparently they just got stuck in bounds, ran out of time, and Denver is your Super Bowl champion. So we'll go back to the presentation here in just a second, but wow, Billy Bravo and company have done it for the second year in a row. Another back-to-back championship run for the Broncos.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gaughton signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
So like I said, all Billy Bravo does is win championships in Major League Baseball, and now in the NFL, is anybody more important in Denver sports today here than Billy Bravo? At least, well, in our video game world. You see all the stats here, passing, now your rushing stats. C.J. Anderson does not get near 100 yards, but he is effective on the day to set up what we needed to get done, and it was a close one, much closer than Super Bowl 33. And it is a 17-14 Denver Broncos win to claim the world championship on back-to-back seasons. First Peyton Manning, now Billy Bravo, as you see some of the things he accomplished here this year, looking at some of his dynamic goals, his milestone goals, all of that, and it's in the books. So, Denver Broncos win the Super Bowl. Here we'll be setting up for another season, his second season, We'll kind of recap what happens in the draft and what will be going forward here for the Denver Broncos. But for now, call them the champs again. We'll see you next time.